Let's see if I remember what I left here. I don't know if I prefer the shooting up games that let you change your ship speed between like three different speeds or not. Oh good, I'm really shocked I was able to do that without a bomb. So is that. Yeah, at least I can see the bullets now. Unlike the previous couple levels. Oh, I didn't see that one. Okay, that was decent. I did not think I was gonna live through that. Or that. I'm surprised those big ships don't give you power-ups. Oh, that was so close. Full power, homing, give me the laser, come on. There we go. Now I can no longer see the bullets because they blend into the ground. I was doing so good with the space background. But oh, they have to be fancy. Here's different backgrounds. I would prefer if the whole game was just the black and blue space with the stars. Or change the color of the bullets. They were not thinking about people with poor vision when they made this, apparently. Green's the ship that I like. Did not mean to grab that. If I didn't get the same one, I would have been in a level 1 laser instead of whatever level 2 this is. So it made more sense to get a level 2 weapon versus the level 1 that I actually like. I had to use a bomb here. And I was too late hitting it. Single drill. I prefer the green ships. Of course they were. I was like, oh, finally an easy level. And then nope. A planet that blends in with the bullets. Like, of course. I was doing so well in this level, too. Until the background change. First-person shooters count as shooting-type games, right? It's been ages since I played an FPS, and I thought since I'm playing shooting type games this month in September, and it's still pretty early in September, I could maybe do FPS and still finish it before my October stuff. Maybe. Especially if I'm going to keep running into these types of games with bullets that I literally cannot see. I'm going left and right, hoping that the bullets won't hit me. Because I cannot see them. I might as well do that section with my eyes closed. Luckily, these ships shoot where you are, so my strafing left and right works. But the tanks here, the little turrets shoot where you are, like the ships. But then they have a pattern shot like that, which I just blew through all my bombs because I'm mostly dead otherwise. Please be a checkpoint. Get me away from this planet. I have no bombs. That's probably not a checkpoint. Oh, it is. Good. Now I have to crawl to the next checkpoint. Okay, that would have been good. Throw a bomb. So yeah, I'm thinking of going to a first-person shooter after this game. It would have to be a short one, and maybe one that doesn't require a bunch of aiming, because with my eyesight, there's a reason I avoid playing first-person shooters often. I like them, but I cannot aim with the how poor my eyesight is. Okay, this might be a little easier. As long as I can take out these stupid blue things before they get too far ahead. Oh, of course. I'm not gonna get that power up again anytime soon. I wonder if there's any easier first-person shooters on the Switch. What if I just never break these? Will they not shoot? Oh, never mind. I fucked that up. If the blue ones don't shoot until you break them, maybe I just don't break them. Those ones do though. Oh, I'm screwed. I'm so screwed. Again. That was luck. I have no bombs now, but come on, give me something good. I'm shocked I didn't die. Those bullets I dodged was pure luck. I have no idea how I dodged all that. That was a complete accident. And here's the boss. And I have one bomb. I guess I'm gonna hang back and see the bullet pattern before I throw my bomb. I don't like being this close to it. Oh, of course. Okay. Not shooting the blue tank things worked. So that was nice. I hope that one's always drops four. It is good. And full power. And three bombs. Okay. I still don't know the boss pattern, but it's definitely doable with this loadout. As much as I'd love to do Turok 2 after this, I really think that one's too big of a game, especially with the maze-like levels. So close. Of course I'd die there. dodging there. I think I've got it now. If I could just save my bombs and also have a run where I get the full powered laser, I think I could do it. And again, I'm basically doing this with my eyes closed, because it's the orange background and I can't see the bullets, especially the fast shots that the boss is doing. Feel like I've gotta be getting close to the end of the game. I think this is Act 6 or whatever. If I remember right. Yeah, that didn't work. Okay, here we go. Oh! I was gonna say I can work with that, and I'm dead. The laser doesn't hit enemies in wide area like some weapons, but it does higher concentrations of damage if I can actually get in front of what I'm trying to shoot, which is not always the case. I'm still dead. I used a bomb and I still died there. So if you can get direct fire onto the enemy, the laser does way more damage. Like, the pieces would break off way quicker. I wish it didn't start so close to you. That was luck that I didn't die there. I couldn't get back in front of it. Maybe I'll try a different weapon for once. Thank you. Like, of course, the boss had to be a tank, so that it needed ground. Tanks can fly in space. Yeah, no, I hate that weapon. That was close. I somehow have to save my bombs for the last phase. Because if I get out from in front of it, then I'm dead if I don't have bombs, because I can't get back in front of it.
Oh, that's really close.
Bomb, I'm mashing bomb. No, double kill. Are you shitting me? That was it. I couldn't have lived for a few more seconds. That was so close. There's another boss I did that with. I can't remember which one though. But I also got a double kill on that and I was upset. That was really close. Just get me out of this hole. Yeah, see, I don't have the spread to be able to move and hit it when I don't have the full power. So I think my only chance of beating this boss is to get the lucky drop. The max laser is so concentrated, I can take out the turrets as fast as I need when I'm going back and forth, dodging the bullets I can't see. But with the single beam, I have to actually aim, at which point I can no longer dodge the bullets. Level 1, I'm definitely dead. There's no way I could win with this. just so bad. I think I have to use a bomb there. Oh, this is it. Here we go. I didn't get the third bomb off in time. Yeah, it feels impossible without the max shot. I think it's funny I still play these games, even when I'm literally fighting against them with my poor vision to actually be able to do the things they're asking. Yeah, and that wasn't happening. Maybe I shouldn't even attempt it without the full power up. Yeah, I feel like I've played a bunch of shoot 'em ups already. I kind of feel like swapping to a first person shooter for maybe the rest of the month, depending on how long it takes me to finish one, obviously. My allergies are bothering me today. I am ready for fall. Oh, here we go. How many attempts was that between the getting this drop this time and last? 3 or 4 at least. You might as well blindfold me for this boss. I'm done. There's no winning with that combo. This is why I usually stick to platforms. Don't run into these issues with platformers typically. Yeah, I don't know why I'm attempting this. There's no way I have enough TPS with this one little beam to be able to break all these and not get hit without having to do so many more passes. Damage, but I didn't think I'd get as far as I did that attempt, so that's something, I guess. I'm shocked that bullet didn't get me. My import copy of the Steelbook Collector's Edition 4K version of It Follows is shipping. I have 4 bombs there. I did not realize that. Oh yes, no. I got hit trying to grab it. Okay, I'm gonna stop using my bomb at the start of this section. I say that, and then if I had cleared more of those out, I might have lived. Yeah, I think a first person shooter would be a nice change of pace. And as long as I pick one that isn't too long or difficult for me, I think that would be a fun thing to play, because I'm not very good at it. That was so close. I guess I'm just gonna look for that one set of drops. No, that was it. I guess this is workable, maybe. should have bombed. So I'm gonna start with a bomb and see how that goes. Cause I'll still have 3 bombs for the end if this works. No. Couldn't get out of the way in time. I can't think of very many first person shooters I have on the Switch. Getting to change the color of the bullets should be standard in games like this for people who can't see. Like, this is getting a little ridiculous, this one boss. Make the planet purple, like, come on. Something I can see the bullets against. Besides the not being very accessible, I've enjoyed this game. I feel like I'm getting very near the end. Okay, here we go. No lives, but it's not like dying doesn't send me back anyway. It's hard to get between the bullet pattern if I can't see it in the first place. At least I've gotten to the point where I don't have to use a bomb at the start. Nope, again, not what I'm looking for. Drops wise. This is gonna be luck if I beat this boss. And that sucks. And it wouldn't have been hard. All they have to do is change the color of the ground here. Something that didn't match the bullets. Or have no ground and put me back in space. I much would have preferred that. I at least would have had a fighting chance then. So besides my nitpicks about not being able to see for a good chunk of this game, I've enjoyed what I've actually been able to see. those were the drops I wanted. Now it's gonna take me 2 or 3 runs before I see that anymore. Stuff for games way back when this came out. Like, changing the color and size of the bullets should be standard in something like this. I'm shocked I grabbed that and didn't run. Okay, popped both of those at the same time. This is gonna be very close. Nope. I didn't even see that one that I ran into. This is starting to feel like an exercise in futility. So close. So I guess I'm just gonna have to, whenever I decide to play games like this, stop when I see that I can't progress without struggling a whole bunch because of the backgrounds and being able to see the bullets. Finished watching Across the Spider-Verse this weekend. It was so good. It looked amazing in 4K. Get out of the way. Oh no. That was really close. That was a very close attempt. I feel like if I hadn't died there, my little homing rockets would have finished it. All I had to do was not die. That was the power up I was looking for. Oh well. At least I have 4 bullets and the laser. 4 bombs. Yep, I did not think I was gonna make that. I bet people with better eyesight don't even have to think about how small the bullets are, or what color they are against what color background. Yeah, I might be done with this one. This was good. They had some other sections in this game where the bullets were hard to see against the background, but it was like near the beginning, and then there were more sections where they didn't blend in so much until this point. Oh. Dodge these bullets, take out the big ship, and dodge these ships and all the shots. And pick up the power-ups. Might as well be just blindfolded for this. That wasn't the drops I wanted. I can't seem to get past this opening anymore. And that was the one that I wanted. Finish this one, I'm still going to go back and forth with Death Ray Manta while I'm playing a first person shooter for the month. While I have my issues being able to play first person shooters, it won't be like this, where I literally can't see the things coming at me. I'm shocked. All that was luck. Any dodging that looked like I was doing was complete luck there. It's impossible to dodge bullets when you literally can't see them. So I was just weaving, trying to pick up the power-ups, completely ignoring the bullets because it's not like I can see them anyway. And I'm shocked that worked. Wow. I used 2 bombs and I still couldn't. me back in space. Come on. Yeah, but that sucks. Getting this far into the game and not being able to finish because of a little thing like my poor vision. But I guess that's how it goes with these older games. That was absolute luck. So was that. I'm shocked I'm still alive. And have the 4 bombs. But it's not like I could drop a bomb and be able to block the bullets that I still can't see.
Oh, that was so close.
Come on, pop already. Come on. There we go. Good. That was so close. Okay, here we go. If I had had this last, watch me screw up immediately. If I had had this last attempt, I actually absolutely would have won, because this does so much more damage, and so I wouldn't have had to stay alive as long.
Oh, that was close.
Nope. I knew I was gonna screw that up. Get me out of this level, please. And then credits. Okay, there's no way I could have had. We're slowly passing the point where I'm okay with some of the design decisions in this. That was the power of it. chose to use the bombs before the boss scene. Even though a lot of times it's like, how am I supposed to get through this? That was luck that I dodged that bullet. I didn't see it till it was too late, but the shot missed in there too. Was really close. I didn't even see that bullet. I thought, yes, I'm home free. I just have to live and let my little homing rockets do the rest, which is why I think the homing rockets is the best weapon, sub-weapon in this game, because it's hard enough for me to dodge the bullets and shoot, much less aim and dodge bullets that are literally invisible to me. I just find it frustrating that at least if you're going to be blatant with your "we don't care about people with poor eyesight," do it at the beginning so I can stop at the beginning, not get all the way to the end of the game and then be like, okay, now we don't care if you can't see or not. Every time I've gotten the power up, I've screwed up the boss pattern. I kinda have to do the boss in the exact same way every time. I couldn't see any of that. Every time I get the big laser, I can't do the boss pattern. Every time. Yeah, I think if I don't beat this session, I'm not coming back. Because fuck this. I really think I would do just as well at this with my eyes closed. I can't even do the beginning section now. The laser, at least. Laser. I think homing needs to be one of the first ones that I pick up. Because then I don't have to worry about shooting the tanks, and I just have to worry about going back and forth and running into the bullets that I can't see.
Oh,
don't go to the top of the screen. That was the drop I wanted to. It's been over an hour and I've been on this one level because of the design decisions. Do the beginning on the times that I can get the drop time on. Not what I wanted, but I can sort of work with this maybe if I get a good ball spanning. Bullets are just so small and fast. Yeah, no. Oh, dead instantly. I think I'm done. This was a good. I enjoyed this until this level. Like, I've gotten stuck before, but. We've never had an orange background with the orange bullets. I don't know who thought that was a good idea. I'm not even gonna do the suspend save because I'm gonna uninstall this as soon as I'm done, I think. So definitely the next time we play, it'll be either Death Ray Manta or a first person shooter. I'm gonna have to look through my a very long list of games on the Switch to see which first-person shooters I want to play. I did do them already. I did Turok 1 already. I don't want to do the second games in either of those series. Fuck. Okay, yeah. I'm done. I'm not even doing the quick save there. I wonder, let's look. Yeah. No more of that. It's gone forever. Yeah. All right, until next time.